I'm Panini Pete, a professional chef with small-town roots and a passion for one-of-a-kind places. I'm day-tripping down the back roads and main streets of America to prove that small towns are extraordinary destinations, each one rich in history and full of happiness, where people care about people and treat you like one of their own. They celebrate life, tradition, and one-of-a-kind food culture. So join me as we gather all the local ingredients to serve up a big helping of small-town flavor.
One star falling.
Welcome to Danville, Kentucky, a true city of firsts with significant historical connections to Kentucky, our country, and even the world. We're going to learn much more about Danville's first along our journey today, but we start off right here early morning on Main Street, right in front of the legendary Burke's Bakery. This is a multi-generational, family-run bakery that's been cranking out a heavenly assortment of baked goods, and they're doing it the old-fashioned way from scratch. So I can't wait to take you inside, see what they've been up to since 3 a.m., introduce you to the family, and maybe even help out. Pleasure. I'm so glad to be here. Thank you so much for taking a little time out of your busy day. Five generations.
Started with my husband's great grandfather. So we're Jody, our son's in here, so that makes him great great grandfather.
Wow.
That started in 1922.
I bet the holidays are a little crazy around here, huh?
They are. We sell about 3,000 dozen butterfly rolls the week of Christmas, which we're famous for. That's
3,000 dozen?
3,000 dozen.
Of these?
Of those.
What is this? This is a butterfly roll?
That's a butterfly roll.
Well, I'd love to learn more about the family, and you know, if you could give me a little guided tour, maybe if I could even get dirty, I kind of, you know.
Be glad for you.
You don't have anything that I could mess up too bad.
No, no.
Would you mind showing us around?
Not with Jody's guidance. Come on back and let's go see what we can find.
Head to the back.
All right, let's go down here where we do our main baking and cooking and bread
making. Right away, the interstate, you get hit with the heat, you get hit with the smells, and look at this visually too. All your senses here are going berserk right now.
These are the ovens that kind of cook all of our different products. We have two of these.
Well, how long has this been around?
50 years.
We've
50 years? Is, 50-some years. One Christmas, this oven actually broke down.
Oh, and, during Christmas? That's not good.
No, it was not. So it took us 2-3 days to get the part. So we had Danville High School's football team in. Some of the guys came in and hand cranked it on the side.
What?
Yeah, there's a hand crank.
So you had the football team from Danville come in and hand crank the oven?
Maybe.
For how long did they have to do that?
About 3 days.
Three days.
They
came in. Those guys, they probably won a championship that year.
We told them they could have anything they could eat.
That was probably dangerous for football players.
It was, but we were very grateful to have them come in because it was crucial to keep this oven rolling. The salt rice and bread's what we are famous for. It's a three-stage bread, so, and some days it rises, some days it doesn't.
Wow.
This is one of my sons, and he comes in every night and sets it.
What's going on? I'm Pete, how you doing? My pleasure.
You kind of set that salt rising every night.
One of the Burks here, huh?
Yeah, I think we started here.
6:30 every night. We started at 4 in the morning. Now 4 or 5 in the morning. Then he comes back in, sets it, and then we have to redo it again when we come in the morning.
Who's this character over here? Does he know what he's doing? He
looks sometimes. Like this is my son, Jody.
What's going on, buddy? Good to meet you, man.
We're still doing things the same way we did them 50 years ago.
Absolutely.
Pretty much. It's a scratch bakery.
It's a 1950s format. It's still all handmade. nothing has changed.
This is really almost a lost art. You know how when you're going on those road trips like I do with my wife and I take a shortcut and it always ends up being a big mistake? Same thing applies to baking. Don't take the shortcuts. Come out with a great product. Well, I'd love to see some more.
How about if we go back up here and see what else is going on?
All right, so this is where they decorate the cakes back
here. This is where we decorate the cakes. Come on back.
This is where the pretty stuff happens.
Here's my husband, Joe. He helps run this bakery.
Joe. Good to see you. Another Burke.
This is the man
of the hour.
Pleasure.
Tell me a little bit about your role here. You're the early guy, huh?
I am that. Originally, we were wholesale bread.
Wow. That's a tough duty.
Yeah, that's tough. But then we, but that's so long ago, I wasn't even born.
Wow.
Now so we're pastries.
You say originally, you're going back in the day.
Yes, way back. Good. And now we're pastries and cakes.
Beautiful. And the donuts I hear are to die for.
Well, we'll get it right usually.
These are the little stations here. You got your cake stands.
Yes,
look at this. This has been around a while too.
Yes.
This should probably be in the Witco.
We don't replace much. If it's not broken, not broken, it doesn't get replaced.
That's an antique. American pickers are going to come through here.
That's the best one.
Yeah. Talk about grease lightning. Whoop. How long have you been decorating cakes here?
I've worked here 20 years.
20 years.
She was a baby when she came.
Sam Burke taught us how to decorate, how he wanted the cakes, and how he designed them, and we taught all the other decorators.
And that's Sam is your father-in-law?
That is my father-in-law. One time, we delivered these wedding cakes, and he sent his son, Lewis, that was in here from college, out, and we had three wedding cakes in one van going the same directions. The van wrecked.
Oh, no.
Yes, it did. So they brought them all back. They redid them, got them all where they were supposed to go on time. But that was the last time three wedding cakes went in one car. They decided that was
how
not a good plan.
Spread them out.
Right, they spread them out.
I thought the football team happened to crank the oven was bad.
The
wedding cake crash. That's another legendary event.
It was.
Look at that beautiful cake. And that took about 47 seconds.
Man. Try that cake, boss.
Talent. That is talent. The rose is beautiful. So, you want to try to teach me how to make a rose right on the cardboard? Master Baker, 20 years at Burke's, is going to try, attempt.
We just count. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I don't know why I'm nervous. It's only a flower. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's a different variety of flower. I think that's a tulip. If a dog wants a cake, wants to resemble his business, I can do that decorating. The secrets of Sam's method are safe. This is not for personal gain or anything, but for the show and for the audience. I occasionally like to sample some of the product. Do you think that would be possible? I'd go out there and eat some of this stuff. I mean, it's for the cause. It's for the cause, right?
We're going to.
Just for you guys. Thanks. All right, so tell me what we have here.
Well, this is just an assortment of some of the things that we make here. This is a cream horn. It's hand done, and these are called our little pedophores. These are our hand cut donuts. These little gingerbread men, believe it or not, they sell for 80 cents a piece. Cinnamon donut. These are our little cupcakes with little John Deere's. Every day there's something different on the little cupcakes, so cannot make enough donut holes. Yeah. This is the caramel pecan twist, and this is a big favorite by people.
Incredible.
This is called a Persian roll, nice. And then this is a chocolate cake donut.
What is this right here?
That is called a chocolate delight, and
that looks...
we sell a lot of those. That's a chocolate devil's food cake with a white Holland cream and then a chocolate poured icing on it.
Well, I guess at this point, it's time I need to try some of this.
Right, try it and see what you
think. I might need a bib or something.
Right.
I'm going to go for the cream horn first. Wow, that's great. Everything made from scratch.
Sometimes you kind of wear what you eat with that one. You're doing a pretty good job. I'm proud of you.
I'm a professional.
You're
here.
A pro at this one, okay.
And this is a pecan.
It's a caramel pecan.
Caramel pecan, look at that.
Caramel pecan, Rob. We don't know.
That's delicious. I got a lot of stuff to try here.
I want to try this gingerbread.
Gingerbread man?
I do.
I'm putting that out, but they're doing good. I can see why you sell a lot of those.
Yes, we do sell a lot of those.
This one's for you, Isabella. Whoa.
I can't eat a whole one. I can eat a half one.
Holy moly. That's a devil dog on steroids. Wow, is that great? The cake is incredible.
And we did make a bigger version of that one, too.
You do? Good. We'll need one of those to go in case we have to do any shoots later.
But it's kind of like that.
Look at that.
Yeah, that's called a Congo pie, but it's actually made out of the same thing this chocolate delight's made out of.
You definitely want to come here and get a Congo pie. I've got to go for the
chocolate
donut.
Cake donut.
I grew up on chocolate donuts. So this is a cake style?
That's a cake style. I do have chocolate flakes.
That chocolate icing is so good.
School children that come through here, which we do tours, it has to be after hours, but when they come through, I tell them this. This is why you go to school. Number one thing you need to learn, though, in your life is good manners.
Absolutely.
Good manners will take you the rest of your life in lots of places, open doors for you.
Man, after really diving into all this great, made from scratch, fresh stuff, I think I'm ready to get back there and get my hands dirty. I'm kind of getting the story, buying into it, and getting the ledge. I think
that,
I'm ready.
All right, if you want to do that, let's go find Jody and let's try.
Cut me loose. Come on.
All right, let's go.
Wonderful. So here we are, we're in the back. I'm with the bad boy of the bake shop back here, Jody Burke. This guy was a state champ wrestler.
State champ.
And a guy
wrestler.
You don't want to mess with on the mat or back here on the make table. We're going to bust out some donuts here, right?
Some glazed donuts.
You're fifth generation.
Fifth generation
baker. Keeping it going.
Keeping it going. And we're just trying to get it to a nice, good thickness. Get it nice, not too thin.
And then once again, you can tell how good somebody is by how easy they make that look.
You'll make real small donuts unless you shake it out like a carpet.
Look at that. Like a magic carpet. Floats.
Yeah. And then we're still in the 50s. We're doing all hand cut, no machinery.
Look at that cutter. Where'd you come up with this?
Oh, they still sell them here and there.
This thing's heavy.
We're just going to try to go down through here, and we're going to try to cut them and catch them on our thumb.
Are these all the same size?
Oh, yes. Boom. Now that's slow.
Is that trick photography?
Yes. That's slow, though. You got to get some
Holy
speed going.
Smokes. Oh, look at this. He's just showing off. All right, let me try it. So down and up, you flip it or
down
something?
Down and flip it. Yeah, you got to catch it on your on your hand there and kind of go right on your thumb. Yes, take a little practice.
Oh, I didn't even get through that one.
There you go.
Oh, you're going to be able to sell these. And then you catch it like that?
Catch it like that.
Oh, this is... One more. Oh, dude, I'm going to jack up this whole dough. Hey! Hey, the Flying Walendas. I got to see this. Get back in there, man. This is something... Hold on. You get right down here. Look at that.
Kind of jerk them up out of there.
You can sell tickets to this. This is like SeaWorld. You know, you come in and watch Shamu.
I just kind of roll back through there.
This is awesome. And then you save the holes, right?
Yes, sir.
Those are one of your popular items, the donut holes. I told you he was the bad boy of the bake shop. Now you know why. This is a PhD in donuts over here, man. It's like a rapid-fire machine gun, man, with the shells just flying out. We got to do that in slow motion. Just pop, 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 pop. They're flying everywhere. What's the next step? Because I'm not even going to attempt this.
All right, well, the first thing we got to do is get it in a proofer, which is steamed water. Just make it warm. We're going to let the dough rise approximately 5-15 minutes, depending on the temperature. And then we're gonna take it out there and drop them in the fryer and fry them up.
Let's do it. We're gonna go finish them up, proof them, and fry them. Proofed. They're ready.
They're proofed.
Got some special grips there.
Got some special
Let's
grips.
Do it.
Keep it out of the grease. Keep your hands out of the grease.
Yeah, that would not be good.
We're gonna hook
They're
it down.
Going down.
Drop it in the grease.
Look at that. They float. Right
they float.
So how long do these have to cook approximately?
30 seconds on side one, 30, 40 seconds.
This is your weapon there, huh? Nice little stick to flip them with?
Yeah, it's my donut sword, so I'm gonna get busy with it.
Whoa, look at that. Don't do anything in slow motion. I don't know if he'd be a good barbecue guy. They talk about low and slow. He'd be like going crazy. Come on, ribs, cook, man.
I can't wait
for that. I'm out of here.
Yeah, but I love barbecue too, man.
It's great to eat.
We're trying to get about the same color. So they're about there.
So you watch them, flip them around a little bit.
Watch
and they come right up in one. That's why you try to keep away from the edges too, I bet.
Absolutely.
I'm gonna do this too now. Is there a front side, a back side? Or
no front side, no back side.
They are hot.
Just kind of warm.
I shouldn't be complaining.
Yeah.
If I was in my place, my cooks would be calling me Sally right now.
Sally?
Say, hey, what's the matter, Sally? Them donuts hot? Yeah, they are.
They're pretty hot now. Now, we had that glazer custom made too, actually.
Really?
Yes, we did.
Necessity, you know, volume increases, the business you're doing, you're always looking for ways to continue to make them for scratch, but in a more productive manner.
Great. So what we do now
because you're so darn slow, you need the help of technology, right?
That's what it is.
Go.
So what we do.
Oh, look at that. And you got a little copper pipe to do that with, huh?
Yeah. Just holds the sticks on there.
Right.
We dip them in, then we're going to set them up.
Start with the top so they come down.
So they don't reach. So we don't, it's called double, we call it double glazing.
Right.
So we don't double glaze them.
All right, so we got this second batch out.
Got the second
batch
out.
I think we're getting ready to roll out of here, man.
Not a problem.
I appreciate it.
Thanks,
man. Thanks for all you do. Not just appreciate you showing us what you do, but just living it. Like you said, you were mentioning that, you know, this is it. This is your place, man. You're where you want to be.
Absolutely.
It's tough some days, but couldn't even dream of being anywhere else.
After you get over the first five minutes in the morning, you're all right.
Oh, it takes the first 5 minutes. You're good. But when you're coming, I'm telling you, it's great. And what you're doing for everybody else, you know, not just the family and carrying on the tradition, but the quality of goods that you're putting out and the care. It's going to be great to show people how much goes into it. They're going to appreciate these donuts even more.
Thank you. We just want to put good
taste and smiles. And the legend of the machine gun.
The legend of the machine gun.
Well, I got to roll and you got donuts to dip.
Well, thank you. Thank you for
thank
taking
you.
Such
pleasure,
an interest.
Pleasure, man. Pleasure.